broadcasting from our studios in the Pines, St. Michael. This is CBC Newsnight, starting now.
Very good evening. I'm Lisa Broom with the CBC Newsnight. A statue will be erected at Barclays Park in St. Andrew in memory of Ermy Bourne, the first woman to serve as a Member of Parliament in Barbados. The announcement from Prime Minister Mia Amor-Motley during the Barbados Labour Party's annual Founders Day picnic on the East Coast Road this afternoon. Lisa Lord has those details.
In front of a sea of thousands of supporters wearing red shirts with slogans like "Stay the course" and "We got this," Prime Minister Motley indicated that the future statue of the late former female politician will serve as a reminder to thousands of young women across the island that they too can reach high office.
So that every Barbadian little girl running about here, or on any other future day that you run about, and you go and see that statue, and you ask somebody, "Mommy, who is she? Granny, who is she? Daddy, who is she?" They will tell you that she was the first woman ever to represent people in the Parliament of Barbados in this country. And that she did it with Sir Gradley Adams, who was her leader at the time.
The BLP administration is less than a month away from celebrating its first anniversary in office. Prime Minister Motley says it has not been an easy road, but there is a lot to celebrate. She says the party plans to do this in a major way come May 24th. The Prime Minister notes that her government has been able to get the South Coast Sewage Treatment Facility functioning properly again and has restored free tuition at the University of the West Indies, among several other achievements. She says despite the naysayers and detractors, the economy has stabilized, confidence has returned, and investors are once again keen. Ms. Motley says her party has been honest with the country about the challenges.
"We never came to fool you. We have told you from day one that you have given us a mandate to provide permanent solutions to you and your family, not quick fixes, not a quick fix to make you feel good for 1 minute and by tomorrow you're catching your tail again. That belongs to those who won in 2013, who made people feel good. And within 3 months, you know that you had made the worst decision in your life. The difference with us is judge a man or a woman by who they start out and what they start out to do."
The Prime Minister has thanked all members of her team and supporters for sticking with the party as it guides the country through the rough times. Lisa Lord, CBC News.
The Barbados Workers Union has come out in defense of at least one holiday following concerns expressed by the number of bank holidays and the loss of revenue. General Secretary Senator Tony Moore has made it clear that International Labor Day, commonly referred to as May Day, is here to stay. She says the value of work and employees must be celebrated. She made the comments as the BWU started its May Day activities with a service at the Solidarity House headquarters.
"First, too, need a day for positive rest and reflection. And I know that there are some workers that if they don't get it one way, they get it another. And we wouldn't want to see that happening. So I'm sure that in our calculations of productivity loss, we know that there's productivity to begin when people feel respected and appreciated and that they are valued as they continue to give value to the development of this nation."
The Barbados Association of Journalists and Media Workers, or BARJAM, has paid tribute to veteran broadcaster Vere Walcott, who passed away yesterday. President Emmanuel Joseph has described Walcott as a godly man and a professional journalist. Joseph, who worked with him during part of his career, says his death is a major loss to the media fraternity.
They were their long-standing colleagues in the broadcasting field. He impacted the lives of many people. This is uplifting and inspirational radio program on Starcom Network. However, the illness that she battled for some time forced him to be off the air for a while, and then he later slowly got back on his feet before losing the battle. He worked closely in the news media for years with me, and while we were at CBC, he became to be popularly known as Charlie Bravo. Even to this day, due to his expertise as an amateur radio operator, but more particularly when he made history by broadcasting live a daily traffic report from a helicopter.
Well, unity was the main theme this weekend as thousands of Barbadians and visitors patronized two of the main events of the Barbados Reggae Festival. We have more in this report from Lorna Jones.
It was standing room only for patrons at Sunday's Reggae Beach Party. Although not feeling 100%, Busy Signal delivered a solid performance from the moment he stepped on stage just after 10 p.m. He had the crowd singing along as he went through his hits, including the ever-popular Stay So. Up next was Sizzler. The highlight of his hour-long set came when Spragabends, Wayne Wonder, and Agent Sasko joined him on stage.
It was real beautiful, you know what I'm saying? With the likes of the people supporting Sizzler with that energy. Sasko, Spragabends, Wayne Wonder, yo, show a mashup.
Now those three were also part of Saturday's Long Walk to Freedom concert, which featured headliner Buju Banton. Both Wayne Wonder and Spragabends told us how they felt to be involved in Buju's historic return to the Barbadian stage.
Me and Buju go way back, so, you know, it's always a pleasure, you know, working together over the years, and we can reconnect back after so much years, you know, so I always look forward to working with my DJ, man.
I'm elated about that, you know. If they asked me to come to the show tonight, I probably would have came free. Don't tell the promoter though, but you know, I think I would have come free just to be here to be a part of this, because Buju is a person that actually was very instrumental in my beginning.
Well, the man himself did not disappoint. From the moment the opening notes of Destiny started playing, a scan of the crowd showed thousands of patrons with cell phones up to capture the moment Buju entered the stage. The mega reggae star then followed with other hits like Not an Easy Road, Hills and Valleys, Only Man, Champion, and One to One. He was joined by Wayne Wonder for I Don't Know Why, and the camaraderie between the stars was evident. After a quick wardrobe change, he came back with more, including African Pride and Magic City. Next up will be Vintage Reggae, the final event for the Barbados Reggae Festival, which comes off on Tuesday night at the Kensington Oval. Lorna Jones, CBC News.
A businessman in Trinidad and Tobago has shot dead two suspected bandits who attempted to rob his liquor mart early this morning. One of them has been identified as 14-year-old Luke Williams, a pupil of St. Anthony's College. Police said they entered Singh's Liquor Mart at Bourne's Road at around 8:20 and ordered the owner to hand over cash and other items. Well, instead, he pulled out his licensed firearm and fired several shots at the two. The boy succumbed to his injuries on the inside of the store, while the man, well, he died on the outside of the business place. International news now. China has banned all variants of the drug fentanyl. This is a step that's welcomed by the United States President Donald Trump to stem the flow of lethal opioids responsible for 48,000 deaths in the U.S. last year. But the drug is not just entering the country directly from China. It's also being imported by Mexican drug cartels.
Three young men out in the woods in Sinaloa, Mexico. It only takes these pots and pans to cook up a drug that's wreaking havoc in the U.S. Fentanyl, the synthetic opioid that's killed tens of thousands in the last 6 years. Some of it enters the U.S. directly from China, but Mexican traffickers are also importing it from the Asian nation before processing and smuggling it across the border. For them, it's a gift, about 50 times more powerful than the poppy-based heroin they've been growing in the mountains here for decades, and far less work.
Growing the poppies is a three-month process. Fentanyl comes in by ship to Mazatlan Port from China or Germany, and it gives better profits. Poppy-based opium means a lot more investment and less money.
The cooking's done in these floating labs, set up in the middle of nowhere.
We got this area very controlled. You have to be a member of the cartel to be here. If you're not, you're in danger. We're covered by radios and lookouts.
The only threats from the armed forces, the police, they say, have already been bought off.
They're all sorted out. We've made an arrangement with them.
Even so, there's danger. He hopes divine help will ward off the ultra-poisonous fumes. Imagine then consuming the end product. Fentanyl can stop you breathing within minutes. Everyone we talk to knows of the danger to users, but business comes first. However, this drug trafficker told us he worried the fentanyl boom could actually damage business itself in the long term.
I think fentanyl's going to cause a problem because there's so many user deaths. There'll come a moment when the federal government's going to put more and more blocks on this, and it'll be a lot tougher to do business.
Sinaloa's police chief says his force is already working with US agencies to do just that. On the day of our visit, they just made their first fentanyl lab bust, taking thousands of pills. The Chinese government's also acting. They've now banned the drug. That will make it harder for Mexican gangsters to get their hands on it, but they're notorious for always finding a way.